Hello, I'm Mr. R. Niger, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity. I learned this subject from my father, who also was a BSc, a science master, not a theologian. So this subject is very easy to learn, and it is as simple as ABC, but you need to be capable of intuition. So this gospel, Age for Gospel, is part 3 I am presenting here. An example of ideal Levi priest was John the Baptist. He loved God and not the Mammon. Therefore, he lived a simple celibate life in the wilderness, as expected of those dedicated to serve God only. He was preparing people morally strong and suitable enough for Jesus to pollinate their ears with the grains of his word. Thus, Saul and Nicodemus were both healthy plants, that means stalks, but Saul, being still young, the silk threads of his ears were still tender and sticky enough to receive the pollen grains of his word, and therefore he was capable of receiving his word without a physical rebirth. Whereas the silk threads of the ears of the old Nicodemus had not only gone dry, but they had also fallen off the ears, with the result that even if a shower of the pollen grains of his word had fallen on his waxed ears, he would not have been able to understand and receive his word to produce the fruit. Therefore, the only way that was left for Nicodemus to understand and receive his word was to take a physical rebirth in order to reproduce tender and sticky receptive silk threads in his ears. The degree of spiritual blindness that the letters had produced in Saul towards his word was signified by the thickness of scales that came off his eyes when Jesus opened his fourth eye to Holy Spirit through grace. Therefore, everybody is not capable of understanding his word, and the word and the letters in the colleges and universities in the manners of other subjects cannot learn it, and it is preached in spirit to the sensible people, and it is understood through logical reasoning. In the university, they teach letters. A gospel cannot be taught, it is preached. So most of the university professors, they hardly know the difference between teaching and preaching, never mind what type of gospel they will be preaching, you know. Out of the sensible people, one who understand and multiply it through preaching are called the wise men, are sealed through Holy Ghost, and they produce fruit, whilst the others who try to misuse his word, God not only takes away from him his word, but he also leaves them in a state of a great confusion. Remembering that Christ Jesus started his ministry at the age of 30, we can say that the ideal age for receiving gospel is between 30 and 50. That is, a person below the age of 20 normally has not developed his ears to hear his word, whereas a person over the age of 50 is normally too old to understand his word with an open mind. In fact, the children up to the age of 20 should be taught the moral laws of Moses in order to make them physically and mentally hale and healthy, and morally suitable. Salt of the earth is called people who are were shame of Adam or family shame for receiving the spiritual education from the roving royal preachers of God, who, unlike the present clerics, are not the hirelings of Mammon. In a nutshell, obeying of the moral laws by the letters produces a healthy stalk, but it is only the spirit that enables a person to understand and put into practice his word for bearing fruit. The importance of the fruit has been stressed both by John the Baptist and Jesus. John warned the people in Matthew 3:10, "The axe is already at the roots of trees, and every tree that does not produce good fruit will be cut down and thrown into the fire of hell." Whereas Jesus, by making the fig tree wither, fulfilled the warning of John, that is, meagre obeying the moral laws by the letters is not enough, but rather tempering your works with Holy Spirit or mercy. Here it is worth mentioning that the present horrific crimes that the children commit in UK and America, etc., the so-called rich and advanced countries, are the consequences of applying the moral laws by the very letters and not tempering them with the spirit on which the moral laws were originally based upon. Thus, Holy Spirit, which is common sense, shatters the fetters of the letters. Letters mean holy books. Letter killeth, spirit giveth life. Scriptures plus Holy Spirit, which is common sense, equal to gospel. So I hope I made my point clear, and sorry if you haven't, if you can't catch my accent, but that's, you can't help it, you know. I come from the Punjab, India, so my accent is Indian, and if I were born here, then I would have studied English in a school and college, and would have been speaking a better one. However, God bless you, and my lectures are free, and don't forget, you know, anything you want to ask or anything on Bible, I can help you. And I have understood this subject in spirit, not on the basis of the university letters. So I know what I'm talking, so I can explain. But the university professors, they have no idea what they are talking. Ask them why John the Baptist never baptized a woman. They have no clue, but I can explain it in a very simple way and very simple language. God bless you.